My name is Jeff Chan. I'm from the Department of Chemistry. We do chemical biology research as well as organic synthesis. And what we're interested in doing is developing chemical tools that utilize an approach called activity-based chemical activation to impact human health. What activity-based chemical activation means is we target a disease biomarker. So this could be a small molecule, it could be a metal ion, it could be an enzyme that's upregulated in that disease state. And then we tune the chemistry so that we can detect it. The difference between what we're doing is we're targeting biomarkers that are typically really hard to detect. So these could be fleeting species, they could be things that are present at very, very low abundance. And so the ability for us to tune the chemistry to be able to match the reactivity to the availability of that biomarker allows us to really expand the palette of what we can detect. And we can design and make these probes from simple building blocks within our own laboratory to detect these analytes and disease biomarkers that would otherwise be invisible. One of the imaging types that we utilize, that we're really known for, is called photoacoustic imaging. And this is a new technology that's described as a light in sound out technique. So we utilize light to excite the molecule, and instead of detecting light, such as in a fluorescent readout, we're actually detecting ultrasound. And the reason why detecting ultrasound is really powerful is because it can travel through your body unperturbed, and this allows us to be able to obtain much higher resolution, image much deeper into the body. So we've developed a number of different imaging agents for this modality that has allowed us to study aging, cancer, neurological disorders, as well as liver diseases and so forth. So what we do is we develop the chemical. We typically intravenously inject the imaging probe, so they go into the bloodstream and they're able to hone in on the target based on the chemical structures of the molecules. And then you have to come in and externally excite that molecule using light. Once the light interacts with that molecule, it's going to generate an ultrasound readout, which we can detect as sound waves, and then we can triangulate and generate a three-dimensional image. So in the PNAS publication, what we're interested in looking at is aberrant levels of copper. So metal ions are important to the body. Every single living organism requires copper in particular. And our body has evolved a really intricate set of mechanisms to be able to control it. And the reason for that is because too much copper in the body can actually be really harmful, especially when it becomes dysregulated or uncontrolled. And the reason for this is because copper can generate free radicals, and this can damage your DNA, it can damage your protein. So there's a number of diseases where copper becomes dysregulated. One of which that we're really interested in is called Wilson's disease. And this is a genetic disorder which is characterized by a mutation of the ATP7B enzyme. And what this enzyme does is it takes the copper from the liver, it takes the copper from the brain, and exports it out to keep it safe. But if this enzyme has been mutated, what happens over a function of time is that you have accumulation of copper in the brain, you have accumulation of copper in the liver, and this causes damage. And oftentimes it becomes fatal if not treated. The problem is when you perform a biopsy in a hospital setting to tell what levels are present, you're looking at the total copper content. And the total copper content doesn't necessarily translate to the harmful types of copper. The copper that is labile, that is free to generate free radicals, is what's most dangerous. So prior to the development of our molecule, there's actually no other way that you can detect labile copper in a deep tissue context with such high resolution. So being able to match the reactivity of our probe so that we can detect that labile copper and have a readout like photoacoustic imaging, which is that light in, sound out technique, allows us to pinpoint where this is occurring within the cells in the liver. So one of the advantages of using this approach is that you don't actually have to perform any surgery, you don't have to cause any type of incision. All you have to do is administer the imaging agent through the bloodstream, wait a given amount of time so that it can accumulate and localize to the liver, wait for the activation to occur, and you can perform your imaging. As we've shown in our paper, the imaging agent is really safe. It doesn't harm cells, it doesn't cause any type of toxicity, and it doesn't impact liver function, which is really important for patients with this type of disease. One way that you can actually treat Wilson's disease is to apply a copper chelator. Too much of the copper chelator to remove that excess copper in the liver can actually cause damage elsewhere. So you really want to be able to have a fine-tuned level, and our imaging agent will allow us to do that. So it's a tremendous challenge, but it also presents a lot of exciting opportunities to be able to detect, to be able to inform on something that's invisible to the naked eye using small molecules by using this exquisite chemistry is something that, you know, we find very exciting.